First, let's talk a little bit about camera calibration. There are two different types of camera calibration. First is the geometric calibration, where we basically are interested when we look at a 3D scene is how each and every pixel in the real world is relating to directions, angles, shapes, you know, any kind of geometric information in the real world. So that requires us to now calibrate the camera and the location of the camera with respect to the scenes and objects in the scene so we can actually get more 3D information. That's geometric. Of course, we're also interested, remember from our earlier lectures, to be able to capture radiometric, photometric information from a scene, you know, light reflectances and scattering of light information. Here, basically, we're interested in each and every pixel relate to the radiance amounts in the real world. You know, what's happening in a scene? What's the exact radiance value at any point in a scene? How can we capture it onto a pixel in an image? Again, this is the whole pipeline we just saw where we basically want to be able to go from L all the way to I. Now, we studied this a little bit when we did panoramas. Sometimes we might not have the ability to capture everything in a 3D world directly from the sensors. So what we want to do now is take a little bit of a data-driven approach. And basically, that suggests is let's actually do this by looking at a bunch of images, not just one image, and use that information as to how things change when I take a bunch of different images. So for example, here, I may have a color pattern which tells me everything else about it, but I could take a color pattern, a checkered pattern, and move it around. And as I move it around, if knowing a little bit more about the information in that scene, in this case, of course, the exact nature of the structured pattern associated here. And if I look at it from the same camera, I should be able to kind of now get different data at different points. That basically suggests is that now I can get how pixel relates to the geometry in a scene by just looking at a whole lot of other images. Well, the same thing is true in the case of photometric. This was relevant when we looked at the whole case of panoramas. This is more relevant in the kind of world of HDR, where basically now we are trying to relate is how the radiance at any point on the scene is accounting for a specific pixel intensity. And we do this by calibrating a camera by getting a lot of data by the same scene by having different images. Remember again, these were both issues that help us when we start thinking about concepts like epsilon photography.